Was the lie, you hamsters? How the hell are ya? Not too long ago, I released information on how to acquire lich weapons and all that jazz. And if you saw those videos, which I recommend you do in case you need the information, then you probably know that the warframe you use to kill a Kuva larveling will dictate what status damage type the resulting Kuva weapon will have. So a logical question would be, what is the best damage type to aspire for? Does it even matter? And I am here to tell you it kinda does and also does not. You see, all Kuva weapons are better than their originals. And all of them will dominate the entire star chart. So from that perspective it truly does not matter. However, maybe you're a goofball who likes big dick numbers to compensate for other things. If that is the case, then listen here. When hunting liches, make sure you always use a warframe that will put fire on the Kuva weapon. Namely, Lizard Chroma, Hot Chili Ember, the Mummy in Oros, Hulahu Boy Nezzy, Train Man Boobern and Big Booty Wisp. If you kill your Kuva larveling with either of these frames, your weapon will definitely have fire as its base elemental. So now the question might be, why though? Why not go with Toxin or something? Here is the deal, in today's day and age, the most potent damage combo you can have is viral and fire. I will not explain to you how damage works at this point, but in short terms, viral will increase damage enemies can take with each stack. So kinda like a built-in critical multiplier. Which is effective against all enemy factions. Fire will reduce enemy armor. Even though fire is not the best against corpus, the added bonus damage from viral will compensate for that several times over. Now when a weapon already has fire built into it, all you need are two mods, cold and toxin, to create viral that will accompany the heat. If you do this any other way, you will not be able to build for viral and heat. It will either be viral and radiation, or some other shitty combo you will regret. The reason for this is because of the way innate elementals combine with mods. One added elemental will combine with the innate elemental. Elemental mods will combine with each other and ignore the innate elemental. With 3 and above, the last mod you install in a row will always combine with the innate elemental. So if you insist on having radiation, then I suggest you use a warframe that will put that on your weapon instead of later trying to figure out how to force radiation on thereby using mods and probably making that word clueless face you make while watching nightmare frame streams. So what I am trying to get through your thick ass skull is that if you want to be lazy, you can always kill larvelings with fire inducing warframes. The result with the Kuva weapon will be just fine. However, if you want to take it even further and be efficient like a pro Fortnite player, then listen here. First step is to dye your hair blue. You will need that for reasons. Then you may want to categorize all Kuva weapons into 3 groups. Which is exactly what I did for you. Status weapons, critical weapons and hybrid weapons. According to my parameters, a status weapon is a weapon that has a very high status chance and so it would make sense to exploit that. Same with a critical weapon but with crit chance and crit damage. A hybrid weapon, in my opinion, is a weapon that can go either way and still deal stupid damage. According to this logic, and considering that you do not have infinite mob capacity, I can tell you right now that there is a smart way to do this and a stupid way. I know this might be asking too much from you, but today we are going to be smart. If you go after any status heavy Kuva weapon, I would recommend putting toxin on them. The weapons in question are these here and the warframes that add toxin are these. Now you might be wondering, why do this? Well, a status weapon will benefit from mods that add more elementals and further increase status effect chances, right? So it would make sense to set yourself up in a way that encourages using more elemental mods naturally. With Taxin built into your Kuva weapon, you will need to add 1 cold and 1 toxin mod first and lastly 1 heat mod. This gives you 3 elementals and will result in that sexiest team viral and heat combination. Now with the critical Kuva weapon, which would be those here, things get a little tricky. If it happens to be a critical primary weapon, Toxin will do just fine since all you need to add is prime cryo rounds to receive viral. Sure, you could also put on cold and then modify with only infected clip. But last time I checked, prime mods were more powerful than regular ones. With critical secondaries it will not matter. You can go with either since secondaries do not have a prime cold or toxin mods. With melee critical weapons, you should surely put cold on your larveling. Which you can do with either of these warframes. Then you will modify with primed fever strike later to get that sexy viral. The point of this logic is to use only one single elemental mod so you have more room for your stupid big dick red crit builds and shit. So there you go. Now in case you insist on combining heat and viral even on a crit weapon, then forget everything I just said and hunt with heat frames. The thing is though, on critical primaries, you will likely build hunter munitions in there. Which will force slash. That combined with viral can be very nice too, so the aforementioned logic would still apply. On a hybrid Kuva weapon you can simply go with heat as usual. You cannot go wrong with heat. So then, there you have it. The smart and efficient way to figure out what progenitor frame you want to use for your Kuva weapons. Now I am not saying that all other combos are bad. I am simply saying that if you do anything other than this, then you might run into some issues later down the line. Following my steps here, you will definitely have an above average Kuva weapon one way or another. But at the end of the day, you can and should do whatever the hell you want. If you look at your current Kuva weapons and realize you may be screwed up at some point, then just fuse the new and correct element into it to fix it. How to do that you can find in my other Kuva related videos that I will have linked for you. Now like and subscribe to this shitty channel and fuck off.